아리랑 프라임.
Cooking begins with delicious sounds. And then it delights the eyes, and then the taste buds. Cooking is engrossing, satisfying. I'm Matthew Chung. I'm trained in various culinary styles, French, American, but right now my interests are in Korean cuisine, and I'm trying to learn more about it. Finding new ingredients and creating something new with them, that's an amazing experience. Gyeongsangbuk-do, or often shortened to Gyeongbuk, boasts the rich flavors of the seas and the land, and they still cherish the taste of tradition. I'm off to find the unique flavors of Gyeongbuk, known for their fine traditional cuisine and countless specialties. Join me in my search for the delicious flavors of Gyeongbuk. Beautiful natural scenery and timeless cultural heritage. It's not surprising that Gyeongbuk is often called a Korea within Korea. Located in the southeastern part of Korea, Gyeongbuk is surrounded by the sea and the mountains, which provide abundant and diverse food ingredients. Pohang. It's the largest fishing area in the East Sea. The sheer variety of seafood it offers exceeds all expectations. It's hectic aboard a fishing boat. So fishermen need something quick and filling to eat on board. What flavors did these fishermen find in these abundant waters? Fish this fresh is delicious no matter how it's prepared. But the fisherman's favorite is none other than buhe, or raw fish in a spicy cold broth. Buhe, it's simple to make, which is what the fishermen need. At its very heart, it's just chopped up raw halibut with julienne vegetables tossed in. It's finished with a little dried seaweed, and then they add some seasoned gochujang. With pohang-style muhe, you pour plain water over the seasoned raw fish. Even without the use of a stock or a broth, The raw fish is well seasoned with the spicy chili pepper sauce. It's refreshing, tart, and it's got a kick.
You know, I've always found mujer to be a very interesting dish just because, is it a salad or is it a soup? It's really its own thing. It kind of defies classification, and it's a really innovative way, I find, to have Korean-style raw fish. And it's one of those great dishes to have when you don't know what you want to eat, just because it's light, yet it's meaty at the same time because it's full of fish. So you have the light, refreshing aspect, but at the same time, it still satisfies.
Mujer began as a quick and easy meal for fishermen, and it's like eating a bowl of ocean freshness. Guryeongpo Port in Pohang is famous for a special fish delicacy. Around this time of year, Koreans flock to Guryeongpo to enjoy fresh kwamegi at a local festival. Kwamegi is a winter specialty. Droves of people make an annual pilgrimage to this place just to have kwamegi as the winter sets in for the year.
Guryeongpo kwamegi가 어느 산지에서 먹어도 제일 맛있습니다. 네, 한번 놀러 오십시오.
Seeing other people relish it makes me want to try it too.
The great thing about kwamegi is its texture. It's dry, but it's not completely dried, so it's got this pleasant chewiness to it, and it's got this flavor of not just the sea, but the sea breeze is what it tastes like. God, that's good.
What gives kwamegi its signature chewy texture? It's prepared by drying through repeated freezing and thawing by the ocean winds. And through this, the mackerel pike are turned into kwamegi. With no mountains to block out the northwesterly wind, the fish are exposed to the cold air from the land and the warmer, moist air from the sea. And these are the optimal conditions for making kwamegi. Repeated freezing and thawing is what transforms the oily mackerel pike into kwamegi. Until just recently, kwamegi was almost eaten exclusively just in Pohang. But with its addictive taste and high nutritional value, kwamegi has gotten people all over Korea hooked.
Because the kwamegi, the 먹는 법 좀 알려.
요즘 제일 많이 나는 야채와 이 과메기가 삶으로 주로 많이 사 먹죠. 자 배추, 요걸 삼배추라고 하는 거거든요. 뭐 많이 푸짐하게 올려놓고 드시면 돼요. 요즘 한창 맛있을 때거든요. 미역, 물미역 여기 넣고 그래서 과메기. 예. 그래서 또 뭐 있어요. 고추, 마늘. 예, 고추, 마늘. 아주 이건 매운 거예요. 청양이라는 고추 아주 매운 거예요. 우리나라에서. 네. 그래서 이렇게 삼을 사가지고 이렇게 얘부터 막 먼저 먹어.
예, 진짜.
I guess he couldn't wait another moment for that delicious bite.
거북스럽지만.
예. And now it's my turn.
과메기는 그냥 정말 자연 상태에서.
That's the great thing about kwamegi, is that you know, you can have it any which way. You can have it wrapped in kim, which is seaweed or lobster, or in Napa cabbage, and they're completely different experiences both ways. Or you can have it just as is, dipped in a little bit of chogochujang, which is a gochujang, which is Korean red pepper paste that's been mixed with vinegar. So there are all these different ways of having, but each way, it's always packed with flavor, because kwamegi, at its heart, it's a very flavorful ingredient. It's a dried, oily fish. So by its very nature, it'll be very flavorful. But it has this texture that's very unique and particular to it.
Kwamegi is often mixed with vegetables in a tangy gochujang sauce. And this is an easier way for kwamegi beginners to start to enjoy the dried fish.
Doraji, 뭐 파프리카, 우리 또 장파, 그리고 저 양파, 양파 이런 걸로 해서 이런 무침하는 거예요.
So the muchim is interesting because it's almost like a bound salad is what it is, because they take pieces of the kwamegi that's been torn up and they toss it in the chogochujang sauce, and then you have all of these different other vegetables like you would have, you know, when you eat the sam, but instead they're all tossed together. And in particular, I found that this has doraji in it, which is the root of the bellflower. And it goes really well together because it has this crunch to it and a bitterness that really balances out the meaty oiliness of the kwamegi.
Kwamegi is becoming particularly more popular among women these days, as it's said to be good for the skin and to prevent osteoporosis.
So, 모든 위생이 이제 관리가 되는 부분이고요. 네. 보시면 이제 우선 위생복을 착용해 주셔야 되고요.
Before I got to see how kwamegi is mass-produced, I had to undergo a strict sanitization procedure.
저희는 해썹 이제 인증받은 회사로서 이제 모든 제품에 이제 저희가 이제 입고되는 제품들의 생물 화학적 또 물리적 모든 이제 제품들을 관리해서 위생적으로 안전하게 제조해서 고객분들이 드실 수 있도록 나오고 있어요.
Even past the entrance point, I had to go through several more steps to become acceptably clean.
제품이 이제 저희 이제 과메기의 주 원료인 꽁치고요. 불포화 지방산이 많은 꽁치를 사용하고 있고요. 이제 자르는 자 공정이에요. 기계에서 이제 배까지 다 따서 이제 다 손질돼서 나온 이제 꽁치들은요. 이쪽에서 이제 1차적으로 이제 또 한번 세척을 거치게 되어 있어요.
Washing and properly handling the fish is the most important part of producing kwamegi.
네, 과메기 자체가 찬바람을 맞아요.
And this is the all-important drying room.
그럼
does the nutritional value of fresh mackerel pike and kwamegi differ?
과메기를 만들 때 꽁치에 비해서는 과메기를 만들면 갈수록 수분이 줄어듭니다. 수분이 줄어든 만큼 다른 성분이 빠져나가는 것이 아니라 일부 단백질의 경우에는 아미노산으로 변해서 정미 성분이 생기고, 이 정미 성분 중에서도 특이한 것은 핵산의 경우에는요. 우리가 하이포산틴이라든지 이노신이라든지 이노신산과 같은 이런 물질은 꽁치 때보다도 약 3배 내지 4배가 증가하게 됩니다.
Here's a comparison between kwamegi and tuna and beef, all of which are considered very nutritious foods. Kwamegi shows much higher levels of calcium, vitamin A, and iron.
회사가 저쪽에서 이제 진공 포장한 후에 금속 검토를 통과한 제품들이 이렇게 완제품으로 돼서 이제 나오고 있습니다.
Vacuum pack 과메기 are now ready to be shipped all over the world. The United States, Japan, China, and Canada.
미국이나 이렇게 중국 같은 데서는 오히려 로컬인들이 더 관심을 많이 갖고 굉장히 새로운 아이템으로 지금 주목을 받고 있는 걸로 알아요. 그 나라에서들 더 좋아질 수 있도록 하기 위한 노력을 해야 되는데 이제 그게 그 나라 사람들의 입맛에 맞는 소스 개발이라든가 이제 레시피 개발 같은 거를 앞으로 더 노력을 해야 될 것 같습니다.
The natural environment of Gyeongbuk and the culinary skills of the locals have transformed ordinary mackerel pike into something extraordinary. How can I use this ingredient for my own style of cooking? Nestled in the mountains and blessed with rich natural resources, this is Yeongyang. Now I'm headed off to the Seokge family residence, where ancient ways are still observed. I'm told that I can learn a very special age-old cooking method here.
Ah, hey,
어서 오십시오.
예. 지금 그 음식 지미방 체험관이죠.
예.
The traditional recipes of the 음식 지미방 are shared with the public here. People gather here to learn about Korean traditional food in one of its earliest forms. This is Cho Gi-bun, the wife of the 13th head of the Seokge household. Known as Jongbu, she's the one who carries on the family's culinary heritage and teaches it to others. I was given the opportunity to join in on one of the classes.
I'm 음식을 배우고 싶거든요.
굉장히 좋아해요. 지금 애들도 그런 거 먹을 필요가 있는 것 같아요. 워낙에 부모님들 이제 직장 생활하고 바쁘다 보니까 그런 음식들 기회가 잘 없잖아요. 뭐 치킨 시켜 먹고 이러니까.
음식 지미방 was as a family cook.
Dimibang이 나옵니다. 제일 먼저 나오는 게 면, 국수입니다. 두 번째가 만두법, 만두가 나옵니다. 그래서 이게 18가지. 제일 마지막에 가면은 그 할머니께서 이 책을 이리 눈 어두운데 간신히 썼으니 이 뜻을 잘 알아 이대로 시행을 하고 딸 자식들은 각각 벗겨가되 가져갈 생각도 먹지 마라. 부디 이 책이 상하지 않도록 잘 간수를 해서 쉽게 떨어지게 하지 말아라 해놓으셨습니다. 그래서 이거는 복사본이고 원본은 경북대학.
Now, what's written in this book that makes it so priceless? The book's title, 음식 지미방, means the way to understand the flavors of food. This is Korea's first food encyclopedia in Hangul and the oldest cookbook in Asia to be written by a woman. And what kind of person was the author? Surprisingly, I was led to the family's ancestral shrine.
Hey, 이 연장인 누구입니까?
아, 이 마을에 입양하신 정부인
창시 할머니의 연정입니다.
This is Chang Gaehyang, who wrote 음식 디미방. Even in the patriarchal society of Joseon, Chang Gaehyang was still said to have been admired by everyone in the village for her extensive knowledge. Her descendants have held memorial services for her over centuries, which is telling of how much respect that they have for their ancestor.
입양하신 석계 선조와 장씨 할머니의 불천이 제사를 치려놓은 제사입니다. 이 불천이라는 것은 그 시대에 사회적으로 기여한 어른을 영원히 지내주는 제사를 불천이 제사라고 합니다.
Before me, it's what's known as a 제상. Essentially, it's an offering to one's ancestors. Chang Gaehyang made it possible for modern-day Koreans to get a detailed look at the cuisine and the culture of Joseon's nobility, known as Yangban. And that's why her descendants still honor her spirit to this day. What flavors and techniques did she want to pass down through 음식 디미방? I wanted to find out for myself.
우리 오늘 그 첫 번째 요리는 뭐를 예. 만들 거예요?
아, 잡채라고 예. 이름 그대로 여러 가지 채소를 예. 같이 섞어서 할 거예요.
아, 예, 예. 알겠습니다.
The ingredients consist of vegetables such as cucumbers, mushrooms, mung bean sprouts, spinach, and green onion, flour, sesame oil, and the essential Korean seasoning, soy sauce.
여기 이제 석이버섯인데 피를 맑게 해주는 역할을 하거든요. 이렇게 다 말아서 썰기 좋도록 이렇게 썰으면 됩니다.
Julienne vegetables are stir-fried separately. The name 잡채 means mixed vegetables. It's a favorite of Koreans, and here they do it a little bit differently.
채소를 이제 물을 들이는 겁니다. 다음은 이제 요게 동아를 채를 쳐서 데친 거거든요.
동아요?
동아, 요게 동아예요.
그 야채예요?
예, 야채인데 과는 박과예요.
아,
예, 동아라는 채소인데 요거를 이제 우리가 채를 쳐서 소금 넣은 물에서 데쳐냈어요.
아,
데친 것을 요게 분홍색이 맨드라미 꽃물이에요.
아, and here we have
조금만 스푼으로. 예.
We're just gonna do a little drop.
너무 적다. 예, 그거 한번 해보세요.
Little drop. 아, that's beautiful.
Coxcomb flowers are boiled down to make a natural dye for the vegetables.
You can tell the difference when something has been colored artificially and when something has been colored naturally with something like this. It's a bright, vibrant color, but...
So many different vegetables go into making one dish. And then the pheasant meat. It was a delicacy of the Joseon era, and it's placed in the center. Chang Gaehyang included in 음식 디미방 some tips gained from her own cooking experiences.
음식 디미방 책에 요 이제 부글부글 올라오는 것을 솟구치도록 끓여라 했어요. 지금 이제 막 올라오죠. 한번 봐보세요.
네.
네? 이렇게 올라오는 거를 네. 솟구치도록 끓여라.
A lot of work goes into preparing each element, and only natural ingredients are used to color and season the food. This is health food at its best.
이렇게 예쁜 작품이 어떻게 먹어요? 그냥 보면 배불러져요.
근데 우리나라 그 전통 색상이 오방색이거든요.
예.
오방색인데 이제 흰색, 검정, 붉은색, 초록색, 뭐 노란색 이렇게 오방색인데 이 잡채를 보면 아, 이게 오방색을 보는 느낌이 들어요.
예. 예.
Color isn't just for presentation. Different colored foods have different health benefits and nutrients. Thus, a colorful japchae is a nutritionally balanced food. And here's the next dish.
해보면 고기가 찰지지 않고 푸석푸석해가지고.
The most important ingredient is the gray mullet, which is frozen. The pheasant meat and the chopped mushrooms.
이게 이제 생선 등이거든요. 네. 여기 놓고
So to get those really thin slices, you've actually frozen the fish off so that you can get those nice delicate slices. Otherwise, your knife is just going to turn the fish into mush.
The fish fillet can only be sliced as thin as possible when it's slightly frozen. These thin fillet slices will be used as the dumpling wrapper.
예, 꽁고기입니다. 꽁고기 다진 거, 예, 이거 넣고요. 그리고 이거는 이제 표고버섯, 예. 또 새송이버섯, 석이버섯.
First, the pheasant meat and the chopped mushrooms are stir-fried.
소금을 너무 많이 넣으면 좀 이쁘게 잘 안 돼요.
Then they're wrapped in a thin slice of gray mullet fillet.
주방에서 일하는 거, 그 요리사 하는 거는 되게 쉬운 일이 아니겠죠?
그 음식 하는 데는 좀 인내심이 있어야 돼. 요 끝을 전분을 조금 더 발라가 이렇게 마무리를 해서 이렇게 조금.
그러면 몇 분 동안 쪄야 돼요?
요거는 한 12분.
12분.
속이 익었으니까.
예.
요거는.
The foods recorded in 음식 지미방 are mild in flavor because they don't use chili peppers and are mainly braised or steamed. The average lifespan of a Joseon king was 43.3 years, but Jang Gaeyang and her husband enjoyed such simple fare, and they lived to be 82 and 84 years old. If this isn't healthy cooking, what is?
이거 딱 보면은 아 이거는 진짜 그 좋은 재료에서 그 뭐 네. 제대로 된 요리다.
네.
너무 기대해요.
한번 맛을 예. 한번 뭐 잡채 예. 저 위에 젓가락으로 섞어서 예. 예, 여기 한번 조금 덜어서 맛 한번 봐보세요.
예, 이거 다 같이
섞어요. 예, 다 섞었어요. 예. 예.
The 음식 지미방 잡채 should be mixed together with chopsticks right before you eat.
<웃음> 이거는 잡채면요.
예.
아, 이건 다른 잡채는 비교하지도 못해요.
예.
이거는 아니 특히 그 꽝
예.
맛이랑 그 다른 나물 같이 다 먹으면
섞어서
먹으면요. 너무 맛있어요. 계속 먹을게요.
예. 어만두 아까 저기 셰프님 만드는 거니까 이게 찍었어.
예.
초간장에 찍어가 드시면 더 맛있어요.
So this is the 어만두 that we made.
Let's try the gray mullet dumpling. It smells delicious.
그 생선 맛이 먼저 나고
네.
그 다음에는 그 버섯.
버섯.
와, 되게 신기하네요. 그리고 뭐 비린 것도 하나도 안 비린해 보여.
예.
The secret to 음식 지미방 cooking is simple. use the best ingredients and a little seasoning, and either steam or boil the food to enhance the original flavors of the ingredients.
한국 음식의 오리지널, 즉 한국 음식의 원조 또는 원형의 근거가 바로 이 음식 디미방 책 속에 그대로 있기 때문입니다. 이 음식 디미방의 가치는 이미 우리만의 보고가 아닌 전 세계적인 보고로서의 가치가 충분히 있다고 여겨집니다.
The culinary culture and spirit described in 음식 디미방 are honored to this day and will continue to be passed down through generations. 1,000 years ago, the people of this village had little to eat, for much of the land was not arable. Strangely, however, they were strong and lived to an old age. A curious village official looked into this peculiar situation and uncovered its secret. I headed down to Kangu Port, down in Yeongdeok-gun. Will I be able to find their secret to vitality and longevity?
It's a cold winter's morning, and today's catch is being hauled off the boats as we speak. The sun hasn't even risen yet, but this is what it takes to get the freshest possible.
It's not here, apparently. But while people are at home, curled up warm in their beds still, the fishermen are here, hard at work. And the people are here, they're clearly waiting for something. What is it? Boats emerge from the inky black horizon and arrive on the dock. This is it. This is the famous Yeongdeok snow crab. The first thing that they do upon unloading the snow crabs is to line them up by size. It's an order that's emerged from decades of snow crab trading. Prices may differ up to 3 times depending on which line the crabs belong to. And there's more to these snow crabs that meets the eye. This little yellow plastic strip marks the best of the lot, called Pakdar snow crabs. It's the symbol of the freshest and the meatiest Yeongdeok has to offer.
Where are you from?
Daegu.
Daegu? Yes. So, have you lived in Daegu? Yes, I've lived here. I've lived here
for a while.
좀 야문 거, 다리 떨어진 거, 요 위에 깔은 거, 요거는 좀 모른 거거든요. 그래 좋은 거 살라고.
영도 되게 박달 살 수도 있고, 되게 보통 일반계를 살 수 있는데 지금 나가는 가격을 봐가면서 제가 이제 살 거예요.
An auction for Yeongdeok snow crabs has begun. Participants signal their bids with secretive hand gestures. Crabs are priced anew every day at this auction. And as soon as the auction is over, the snow crabs are quickly carted away to maintain their ocean freshness.
This is today's most expensive crab. It went out at 139,000 won. That's about $130. And it's actually really quite exquisite, especially given how heavy it is. I'm really surprised just by its sheer size, and it makes me want to go try some.
Yeongdeok snow crabs were often offered to the king as tribute. Now it's time to taste the famous dish.
안녕하세요.
예, 어서오세요.
여기를 이렇게 눌러보면
여기라나요?
예. 눌러보시면 네. 고기 단단합니다. 예. 단단하면은 살이 꽉 찼는 대게.
아.
소위 말하는 닭달 대게라는 거죠.
아.
알겠습니다.
예.
Steam snow crab is simple to make.
얘는 얼마 동안 그 찌는 거예요?
예, 저희들 집에는 자동화가 되어 있기 때문에 1150초입니다.
1150초.
예.
With its clean marine environment and abundant foods, Yeongduk provides the optimal habitat for fat and sweet snow crabs. That's why the name Yeongduk has become synonymous with top-grade snow crabs. Simple steaming is enough to turn Yeongduk snow crabs into a delicacy. Their long legs are filled with sweet, succulent meat.
Ah, because 이거 되게 찜 이거 완성된 거죠?
예, 그렇습니다. 지금 이렇게 찜을 했는 걸 가지고 저희들이 또 쓰는 그 대사를 잘 밝힐 수 있는 방법을 제가 알려드리겠습니다. 보통 우리 저희들이 서빙을 한다면 예, 여기를 자르고 일단 여기서 이렇게 잘라서 이걸 벌리게 됩니다.
와.
네, 이렇게 벌리게 되면 예. 그다음에 개 포크입니다. 개 포크를 가지고 여기서 이렇게 위로 올립니다. 자.
와. 와. 아니.
어떠세요?
이 세상에서 이렇게 맛있는 게 먹은 적이 없어요.
그렇죠.
아니, 그 진실이에요. 그, 이거는 그냥 뭐 하는 말 아니고요.
예, 알겠습니다. 네. 마치 한 네.
Tender yet firm, buttery and sweet. This is how you have snow crab. But that's not all. You haven't had a snow crab until you've tried this. The innards.
Mm. Mm. 아니, 이거 완전히 그 바다에서 나오는 포아그라 같아요.
예, 그렇죠. 예, 게장을 거기에 넣어서 같이 믹서를 한번 해 드셔보십시오. 자, 이래가
The flavor knocks me back, but here comes another delicacy.
Wow. 아, 향이 좋네요.
향이 좋죠.
네.
드셔보시죠.
네.
숟가락 김, 깨, 참기름. 요거 이외에는 다른 이 들어가는 없습니다. 양념이. 그래서 게장 하나만 가지고 밥을 비벼라. 그래서 게장 비빔밥이라고 나오죠.
The snow crab innards are intensely flavored, so they make for an amazing ingredient.
So there you have it. A lot of people think that snow crab, it's inconvenient to eat or that it's, you know, too much of a luxury. It's really not the case either way. As we've shown you, if you know how to work your way around a crab, you can get that sweet meat out so easily. And it's a luxury, yes, but it's a simple luxury. It's a real luxury. It's one that comes completely unadorned. It's not gilded. It's not over the top. This is the ocean at its finest.
Even without any seasoning or sauce, the snow crab meat and innards are perfect just the way they are. My next destination is a factory where these delicious snow crabs are processed. The crabs are washed as soon as they arrive. The legs are separated from the body and then steamed. Then the crabs go through a machine that removes the meat from the shell and strains out the impurities. What comes out is pure crab meat, ready to be processed.
Almost 80%는 일본으로 수출되고 일본에서는 역시 똑같이 식당에 들어가게 되면 이제 가지고 분할해서 소분해 가지고 이제 식용자재 쓰게 됩니다.
Yongduk snow crabs are making their way around the world, as indicated by increasing exports. This is the Gyeongbuk Food Expo. Here, they feature specialties from various regions in Gyeongbuk. Visitors are excited that they can try all the local flavors of Gyeongbuk in one place. The flavors of Gyeongbuk are heavily tied in history, but they're not staying in the past. They're constantly evolving. Instead of just limiting itself to local specialties, Gyeongbuk food is changing to cater to a larger market. Upon returning to my workshop, I couldn't wait to get my hands on the ingredients and utilize these techniques I learned from Gyeongbuk. I look back on the time I spent there and realize that there was a lot I had learned. Yongduk snow crabs are just great the way they are, which makes it a challenge to work with its natural flavors. Based on what I learned, I came up with a couple of dishes. This is snow crab three ways, and it uses all the parts of the snow crab and really captures its natural flavor without overpowering it with any additional seasonings. The dish, it involves a little roasted potato, a little thinly sliced fennel, but at its heart, it's all about the snow crab. My next dish is based off of the Umshik Timibang's japchae. Colorful vegetables get stir-fried, and you place some chicken meat in the center, and you pour in an ample amount of gravy. The technique is rooted in Umshik Timibang, so what we have is a roasted autumn vegetable japchae. And kwamegi gets a little bit of a makeover so that even first-timers can enjoy it. It's a blend of the traditional with things like seaweed and bellflower root with a couple of unique ingredients like Belgian endive, and it's all bound together with a sumac vinaigrette. I've invited some guests over for a special meal. This is my take on Gyeongbuk cuisine.
There is salad, so we can.
This is an opportunity to share the flavors of kwamegi, snow crab, and umshik jjimibang dishes. The flavors of Gyeongbuk and the techniques that I've learned really resonated with me, so it was important to be able to share that with my guests. Luckily, they seem to be enjoying themselves.
The second course with the kind of the chapche, the play on the chapche, was really nice. It sort of took me back to my food roots, you know, the chicken soup and how it's very homey and comforting. So I really enjoyed that.
I really enjoyed eating the snow crab. And just sort of eating it, like I tried snow crab before, and it was just it on its own. It was just a sample, and it was very good. And it was really great to try it out mixed in with a lot of seasoning and different vegetables. And I really liked the chicken gravy.
Being able to share these flavors of Gyeongbuk was an important culinary step for me to take, and it's one that will resonate with me in the future.
You know, I said at the beginning of this episode that, you know, to really get to know a place and the people from there, you know, you got to get to know its food. And truth be told, I didn't really know that much about the cuisine of Gyeongbuk. And I got fully immersed into it, and I actually got to use some of the ingredients to myself. So, it's taken me to a place that, yeah, I feel closer to this area that actually I have family from. So it was a really, you know, valuable opportunity for me, and also got my hands on some new cooking techniques, some new ingredients. So, can't wait to go back.
I went to Gyeongbuk in search of foods that were rooted in history and distinctly from Gyeongbuk. And there I found something that will keep me coming back in the future. Now I want to share the flavors of Gyeongbuk and the experiences I had with as many people as I can.